I'm going to try to explain how
that's possible. The percentage of oxygen in your blood is really oxygen saturation. So what we're talking about when we talk about oxygen saturation is the percentage of oxygen that is attached to the hemoglobin in your blood. And a really cool discovery was made to know that deoxygenated hemoglobin absorbs more red light and oxygenated hemoglobin absorbs more infrared light. So what an oxygen saturation tester monitor is doing is actually looking at the difference of how much infrared light and how much red light is actually being absorbed.
So when oxygen is pumped out of your heart through your arteries, the blood is red and it's going to go through the arteries all the way to the tissue, whether we're talking about your finger, your heart, your leg, your toes, your brain, wherever the case is, it's oxygenated blood going in and deoxygenated blue blood coming out. No matter where we're talking, it's oxygenated blood coming in and deoxygenated blood coming out. So what the pulse oximeter is doing is it actually is emitting light through these diodes at the top of the pulse oximeter. The infrared, or some people say infrared, light is actually shining through the finger, along with the red light shining through the finger. On the opposite side of the pulse oximeter, we have a receiving detector, which will measure the amounts of infrared or red light, and it actually comes up with a percentage that will tell you.
So now I'm going to show you a couple of ways that you can use your pulse oximeter. Exercising in the gym. Taking a walk down the road. Or using supplemental oxygen.
So this is the finger pulse oximeter that we supply out of AffinityHM.com, and it's very, very low cost, and it's so cool. It works so well. You actually do not need a prescription for this. I'm just going to unbox it to show you exactly what you get whenever you purchase one of these. You have it shipped to your home. Of course, you get your pulse oximeter, you get a nice little lanyard, and a cool little carrying case. Looks like it's made of canvas, very durable. And of course, you get your instructions, which I will recommend that everyone who purchases one of these, you definitely want to read through and follow all of the operator's manual. And so all of that, let's check out the pulse oximeter itself. Now, of course, it comes with a protective little covering over it here that you just peel back. You can probably do it far more easily than I can. Okay, so that comes right off, no problem. And then to turn it on, you just turn it on like here. And then this sort of pinches apart like a clothespin. You stick your finger inside. And remember, we were talking about the light emitters. You can actually see the light blinking in there. And as soon as it picks up your actual pulse rate, it is going to give me an oxygen saturation for me, 98. And wow, look at my heart beating so fast. The YouTube video must make me a little hyper nervous. But look at on the left, you see the pulsating line. Now you're going to want to see that because it's important that it's picking up a good pulse in order for it to give a good accurate reading on the SpO2, which is the oxygen saturation. And so that's how it works. It's really super easy to operate. The batteries just go right here in the back. As you can see, batteries do come with this unit as well. It's got a couple of AA batteries in there. But super easy to operate, super cool. It does have one other feature. You actually can flip the way the reading is showing by pressing the on-off button again, and it'll flip to any direction that you want it to. So that is everything that we have. My name is Chris O'Gwen, AffinityHM.com. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to our video or watch the next video. Have a great day. Bye-bye.